Hello students, once again welcome to the standard 10 subject mathematics, chapter 1, real numbers. Before this we have done theorem 1.4, root 2 is irrational number, that type of questions we have proved. And exercise 1.3 also was in your homework and with the hint I have given you. So I have a confidence that you have done your homework. Now the next topic in this chapter we have revisiting rational numbers and their expansions. About the rational number, in this chapter also we have seen something, and last standard 9th also we have studied about, and their expansion, how to do expansion. Related to that, we have in this theorem 1.5, 1.6 and 1.7. These theorems will give us the idea about the rational number, which type of rational number will have which type of their decimal expansions. So first theorem 1.5 is, let x be a rational number, any rational number is assumed as x, whose decimal expansion terminates, if x is a rational number and its decimal expansion is terminating, non-terminating, recall. In 9th standard, when the number is called terminating and when the number is called non-terminating, you know. Terminating means the division is completed and you are getting at some stage remainder as that type of terminates. If you have the expansion of the rational number x as terminate, then x can be expressed in the form of b upon q. And in that, P and Q are co-prime. This is the condition for P upon Q. They are P and Q, both will be co-prime. And prime factorization of Q, that is denominator Q, is of the form 2 raised to n, 5 raised to n. If Q is in the form of 2 raised to n, 5 raised to n type, then that rational number expansion will be terminating. This is the theorem. Theorem 1.6 also saying the same thing in different way. In different way, how? See, if x equals to p upon q, that x is a rational number, so it can be represented as p upon q, the rational number, such that the prime factorization of q, that is the denominator part, if it's a prime factorization form, is its 2 raised to n, 5 raised to m type, where n, m are non-negative integers, then x has a decimal expansion which terminates. You can say this 1.5 and 1.6 are opposite to each other. In 1.5, if the rational number terminates, then p upon q form, in that q form's factorization will be in this form, 2 raised to n. And in 1.6, reverse is given. If rational number x is equal to p upon q type and in prime factorization of q is in the form of 2 raised to n, 5 raised to n, then decimal expansion will be terminating. In this, if the decimal expansion terminating, then q will be form of this. In this, if q is in the form of 2 raised to n, 5 raised to n, then that decimal expansion will be terminating. So it's a reverse to each other, 1.5 and 1.6. 1.7 is different. It's a understand that x equals to p upon q be a rational number such that the prime factorization of q is not of the form 2 raised to n, 5 raised to n. If we are factorizing q, this denominator is q, and it is not coming in the form of 2 raised to n, 5 raised to n, then what? Where n are non-negative integers, then x has a decimal expansion non-terminating and recurring. What you will say about the expansion? If you will not getting the q's factors as 2 raised to m, 5 raised to m type, then their expansion will be, that expansion will be of non-terminating and recurring. Sorry. Non-terminating means whose ends is in long division, you know, whose ends not coming. Means when you divide, the remainder is not coming zero. Going on, that type of number, that type of decimal expansion you will get here. and it will be recurring. So you to understand this theorem, theoretically also we have seen, to understand this theorems with examples if we go. So exercise 1.4 we have, in that question 1 we have, using this theorem and how to apply this theorem and what is this theorem we can understand with this question. So we go through the question. The question 1 in exercise 1.4 is, without actually performing the long division, don't do the simple division which we were doing in earlier classes, don't do the division, and using this theorem actually, don't do the long division but use this theorem and state whether the following rational numbers will have a dominating decimal expansion or non-dominating decline. When they will, the questions are given and you have to decide that rational numbers when they are having the dominating decimal expansion and when they are having non-dominating recurring type decimal expansion. So if we go one by one, so in the question 1, first number is given in our textbook, exercise 1.4 is 13 upon 3125, we have the question. So this rational number is in the form of P upon Q form, where we have to concentrate on Q, means this denominator part, as for these theorems, we have to concentrate on denominator. Here Q is equal to 3125. If on rough side, if we do the factors of 3125, you know that 5 by dividing 5, 6 to 5 remaining, 5, 6 are 30, 12, 5, 2 are 12, 2 remaining 25, 5 are 25. Then by 5, 1 are 5, 5, 2 are 12, 5 2 are 10, 2 25, 5 5 are 25. Then 5 divides 125, 25 you get, 5 divides 25, 5 you get, 5 divides 5, 1. So 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5 times 5 you are getting off the factors of 3125. You can write 5 is to 5. 5 is to 5, with that in multiply, 2 is to 0, we can write. You know that anything, any non-negative, any non-zero number raised to 0 gives 1. So 2 raised to 0 I can write with 5 is to 5. So this 2 raised to 0 and 5 is to 5 I can write. This can be say that 2 raised to 0 means 2 raised to n type and 5 raised to 5 means 5 raised to n type. When n equals to 0 and 5, m equals to 5. N equals to 0, m equals to 5. And 0 and 5, non-negative integers we have. So what we get with Q as in the form of 2 raised to n, 5 raised to n. Here we have, if theorem in 1.6, if our Q, prime factorization of Q of the form 2 raised to n, 5 raised to n, it is here like that. So theorem 1.6 says that its decimal expansion will be dominating. So that the conclusion here we have by theorem 1.6, that this number 13 upon 3125 will have a dominating decimal expansion. Understood? Example 1. Question 1 is first number. We can understand theorem 1.6 from this example, and in this example we have used theorem 1.6 to conclusion. Next also we will see second number. In question 1 only the second rational number is given, 17 upon 8. Again it is in the P upon Q form. Again we have to concentrate on Q only, where Q equals to 8 we have. Factors of 8, as you know, 2 4s are 8, 2 2s are 4, 2 1s are 2, 2 2 2. 3 times 2 we get. So we can write 2 raised to 3. 2 raised to 3 into 5 raised to 0 we can write this time. As we have written here, 5 raised to 5 was there, 2 raised to 0 we can put with it because it gives 1. Similarly, 2 raised to 3 into 5 raised to 0 we can write here. Again, 2 raised to 3 and 5 raised to 0 can be in the form of 2 raised to n, 5 raised to n, where n equals to 3 and m equals to 0. See, that n equals to 3 and m equals to 0, both are non-negative integers. Again by theorem 1.6, if your Q is in the form of 2 raised to n, 5 raised to n, so here we have the same, our Q is in the form of 2 raised to n, 5 raised to n, what is the conclusion by theorem 1.6 is that the whole rational number 17 upon 8 will have a dominating decimal expansion. will have a decimal expansion which terminates, means terminating decimal expansion.